let's go with the good news story. I think the great news story out of this trade period is Luke Hodge is going to extend his career with the Brisbane Lions. It's a terrific story, and it's a great get and a great coup for the Lions.
Yeah, it is a great story, Kane, I think. And what a great person Luke Hodge is. And I think Brisbane's the winner. And I think Hawthorn's just handled themselves beautifully in this period too. Luke and Alistair Clarkson have spoken extensively. I've spoken to Alistair and the club, and you know they should be applauded. And it's a bit like how many coaches that have come out of Hawthorn. I think this is another similar situation where Brisbane just probably are pinching themselves that they're going to get someone of Luke Hodge's calibre of person and go and teach the not just their young players, but you know they've got pick one coming, so Luke will be a great mentor for that pick, but for their captain Dane Beams, who we also look after, and I know he's excited to be able to pick the brains of Luke Hodge.
Is he set on what he wants to do post football yet? Yeah, clearly a very good media performer, but can coach as well. I think it'd be a shame if he's lost to footy. Is he you know dead set on playing for 2 years and then he'll make his mind up, or how do you see it?
Yeah, I think that's part of the key, that he does really enjoy the media, but I think this year with his coach, you know, his on-ground coaching of the young players down back, he really enjoyed it. He thought his time was done at Hawthorn in terms of that next year they got a lot of the players back, and that he had a really good experience there. And he retired, he was done and dusted. It was his call. Hawthorn would probably have him play next year. There's no, you know, any question of he could have played at Hawthorn again as well. But he thought his time was up, and then Fags and him had a brief chat, and it got him thinking. And Brisbane's the winner.